Movie review, Beckett from fairy tales to reality. In this film, the director combines a horror film with a political conspiracy, and the feeling of helplessness in a foreign country is vividly expressed. The male lead is a restrained boy, and finally becomes a Greek super-British. There is a pity in this. The heroine died too quickly and it was worthless. It was entirely because the hero drove to sleep to die. It was too worthwhile to die. I don't know if this is considered an anti-type, because in the past horror movies, the survivors were usually girls, and boys were often the ones who received their lunch in advance. Except for jumping off a building at the end of the movie, the action of the whole movie is full of clumsy realism. The less dazzling action narrows the distance between the movie and reality, and on the contrary produces the realism of fists and bullets. A feature film of more than 1 hour and 40 minutes is a bit unbearable to the slow pace of European directors. The black male protagonist Beckett and his white girlfriend went on vacation in Greece in April. Even though Beckett was tired at night, it caused a traffic accident and hit a house on the roadside. His girlfriend died in April and he was also injured. Rent a car without airbags? When Beckett was injured, he found a little boy in the house. After calling the police, he was hunted down. He himself didn't understand what was going on. In the process of fleeing, he discovered that the little boy he had met was the nephew who was kidnapped by a popular candidate in Greece. Beckett finally escaped into the US embassy, but was hunted down again by embassy staff. After chasing and killing his embassy staff, he found that the candidate had been assassinated and supporters clashed with the police. At the same time, he also happened to find the right-wing police and women who had been chasing him. After fighting with two right-wing guys and rescuing the kidnapped little boy, Beckett became a hero. Obviously, the kidnappings and assassinations that occurred in Greece were supported by the US intelligence agencies, specifically implemented by local right-wing organizations, but the US government could not publicly admit it, so Beckett had to be taken outside the embassy and killed. However, I feel that the US embassy's handling was too hasty. Not only did it fail to succeed, but it also allowed Beckett to expose the conspiracy of the right-wing forces, which was really lacking in professional standards. The rhythm of the first half of the film is really stretched, and it feels like abandoning the drama many times. The second half is a little better. My girlfriend is basically playing soy sauce in April, not as much as the left-wing German girl who saves the man in the car. In fact, the plot is very simple, but there is no depth, and did not dig into the motives of the US embassy in colluding with right-wing forces. It feels a bit of a simplified version of the spy shadow of the common people, but the plot is really lackluster. It is too difficult to find a black man to be the male lead. Going to Southeast European countries where blacks are scarce is too difficult to hide. If we go to black in France and Germany, it will be better. I can't bear the political correctness of the white left in Europe.
Okay, please support by subscribing to our channel and clicking the like button. See you in the next video.